Oh, I am going to do pavlova pudding. I hope you will enjoy. Australia, New Zealand, people really love this type of a pudding. Pavlova, that means with egg white and sugar. We will see how we are going to do this pavlova pudding. I am going to do with 4 egg whites. That's my recipe. So, instead of making with 4 egg whites, now I am going to use 3 egg whites because I have already done with 4 egg whites and made the pudding, make the pavlova and kept. To make this pavlova pudding, I told you, we have to make with 4 egg whites, but I am making with 3 egg whites because I have already done the baking part of it. See, 3 egg whites I have used. But please use 4 egg whites. Beat it nicely. Little by little, increase the speed. First thing I have to do is to check whether meringue is okay. Now see, it's not drooping. Till you find that it's not drooping, I have to beat the egg whites. Only the egg whites, not a bit of yolk should go in. Now what I am going to do is, I have to start adding, not this spoon. This is a dessert spoon. With this dessert spoon, 1 tablespoon means 2 dessert spoons. So I have to use, actually I have to use 6 dessert spoons, right? So we will see how we are going to do it. It has to be beaten very well. See how it's been beaten. Pavlova, you know. Here I am using about 1/2 teaspoon of vinegar. 1/2 teaspoon vinegar I am using here. Till the sugar dissolves, keep beating. In one direction, whatever said and done, beat it in one direction, okay? While I was doing, I made a small mistake, I have to tell you. Now I have used 3 egg whites, right? I said 4 egg whites means 4 tablespoons. 8 tablespoons I said. And then if you are using 3 egg whites, 6 tablespoons. Now this is a dessert spoon. With the dessert spoon, if I am going to use 8 tablespoons, with this 16 I have to use. With this, I have to use 16 dessert spoons, right? If I am using 6, that is 3 egg whites if I am using, I have to use 12 of these sugar with the spoon. I have to use 12, right? Don't forget. And I used vinegar. Vinegar, about 1/2 teaspoon I used here. When you use, either you use vinegar for about 1/2 teaspoon or we have to use cream of tartar about 1/2 teaspoon. Remember, either vinegar or cream of tartar. Don't forget, while last bit you beat that and take it. Now the meringue is ready. Now you have to see how we are going to do this. Now what I have done here is, see, I have taken a bowl, that is an oven proof dish, and nicely butter it and keep it ready. Pavlova, I told you, it's a lovely pudding. I love this pudding, that's why I'm also talking about it. So much like, you know, I like this pavlova pudding. bottom a little, sides more. It has to come up like that. Oh, it's nice. Oh, it's sweet. Now, what I'm going to do is, that's all. Push, push, push nicely on the sides and all. Lovely like. I'm going to bake for about 45 minutes to 1 hour in 100 centigrades, right? 100 centigrades, I am going to bake it. We'll see how it comes after it's been baked. If you can reduce even 100 centigrades into a little less even, doesn't matter. But it should not get over baked and it should not become too brownish. We will see how it looks once it is baked. Right. Now see my egg white that I have beaten with sugar and made it for the pavlova to get this filling. Now we are going to have a filling also, so you can see how it looks nice, isn't it? Beautiful. Now we can see how we are going to do the filling for this. First thing, I have taken pineapple. This pineapple is only fresh. So I want this fresh pineapple to be used. Right? 1 cup of pineapple pieces I have taken. 1 cup pineapple pieces. And I will put a dessert spoon of sugar. And cook this. Pineapple. If I'm using pineapple, I have to cook this pineapple. You can use apple, pineapple, any hard fruits, not mangoes or anything like, right? So these, if you use, we can see how it looks, okay? See, I'm doing it in a different way. You can see all these, see, the pineapple I'm stewing with a little sugar. Apple, if I am using, I will use a little sugar plus a little lime juice also, because this is acidic, I don't need, but apple will become a little color will change, so we have to use a little lime. Now this is the stewing that I am doing here. All the water dries up, I will keep. So now I will take this out. Now I stewed the pineapple. So we'll slightly rinse the bowl now. Slightly rinse it so that those pieces won't be there. Now, right. Now what I'm going to do is, I will use the milk. Roughly 1.5 cups of milk I need. 1.5 cups of milk. I will put 1/2 cup into this. And 1 cup into that. I need the sugar. Mix it nicely. I took 1/2 cup of milk separately. I will put corn flour, say about 1.5 dessert spoons. 1.5 dessert spoons corn flour I will put. Mix it separately and put it into this. Along with that, can you remember for the pavlova, I used 3 egg whites. The 3 yolks are remaining. I'll add that. If I was using 4 egg whites, 4 yolks will be there. Add all that. Mix it nicely and cook till it gets thicker. Now this is the custard that I am making. 1.5 cups of milk, 4 dessert spoons of sugar I have put, 1.5 dessert spoons of corn flour I have put, and 3 egg yolks. The yolks are going waste, so we have to use the yolks also, and keep cooking till this gets, say about 1 teaspoon of butter I will use. Teaspoon of butter, teaspoon, 1 or 1.5 teaspoons you can use, and mix it well. the custard. This is the custard that we have made. Lovely. Now I will take this out and show you. Have some whipping cream. I'll use the whipping cream also. 1 to 1.5 cups of whipping cream. If you like, you can use whipping cream or you can omit it. But I preferred the whipping cream also coming into this so that it will be nice and tasty. Okay. I have got some fruits. Now I want to show you the fruits now. I have got the kiwi fruits. Dry ones. Kiwi fruits. Dry ones. I have chopped it. Then I have got mangoes. See, dry mangoes, right? I didn't use fresh mango, dry mangoes. See the dry mangoes, which I have nicely chopped it. And apricot. That is also dry apricot, which I have cut and used it. And dry cherries also I have used here. There are 4 kinds of fruits, which I am going to use. A little first here, balance I'll put on top of it, so we'll keep that. I have used apricot, dry mangoes, dry cherries, and what not. Everything that I could use, I am using it so that it will be tasty. Okay. See my pavlova pudding that I am going to use it for you. And it's so nice and tasty. And now I am going to fill into this. What did I tell you? It's Australian, and of course New Zealand people, they are famous festive time like Christmas time. They have all these type of preparation. Now you know what I'm going to use? A little bit of cheese. You know, into this, cheese also goes very well. So I will use a little cheese. Say about 30 grams of cheese. A little more doesn't matter. 30 grams of cheese I am putting, right? Over that, the balance ingredients. What are those? All the dry fruits I am putting it. I think I have to use my fingers because I want that to be nicely spreaded and put all over. Yummy, yummy. And I would love you for you two to have it so that it will be tasty, and of course you will enjoy this type of preparation. My pavlova, how it looks with the custard, with all the fruits that I could use, and try it out and see how it comes. You don't have to go to another country. In your country, you can try it out, this pavlova, and try it, taste and see, because I will come back with another recipe very soon, next week. Thank you for watching and hope to see you soon.